don't suppose there's how I can say to make you change your mind. So I'll just tell you to stay safe. Nan won't take kindly to losing her best customer, especially after letting us carry all this stuff all the way to Ash.
And we wouldn't want to anger old Nan.
You mean, you'll buy some offers? I've got some good stuff for you. Is there how else you need? Righto, here you go. Is there how else you need? Righto, here you go. How else I can do for you? All done then. You don't want me to make you as how else?
I couldn't have made it this far without you, Torgo.
Each parting brings the hope of reunion. I missed you, Clive.
I missed you too.
I'll be all right, Clive. You may have Shiva's strength, but I still have her spirit.
If Sid were here today, I reckon he'd be proud of you, Clive.
He'd be proud of us all.
Don't worry about us. We'll hold off the rabble for as long as you need.
There is still much I would learn of your tale, once this day is done. Until then, all who might come between me and such knowledge shall answer to my spear.
I do not envy them.
Worry not on our welfare. Your foremost concern should be the heart.
You see, Clive, we're not alone. If we are to win the day, we must all play our part. And ours. Ours lies beyond those doors.
We've fought long and hard for this moment. Sid's dream, our dream, is within our grasp.
We need only endure this final trial, and we shall. Together.
You all know what it is that awaits us beyond this gate. And we shall face it together.
Aye.
Seems our host would rather we remain. I will stay them.
We will stay them. Go!
Just don't keep us waiting.
Thank you.
No! No!
Joshua! Joshua! Wake up!
Clive, is that you? This isn't stone here.
Welcome to our darkness. A rift between worlds wherein your kind might reflect.
Show yourself!
Grave and many are the sins of man. And we would have you know them. All of them. As fate has seen fit to deliver you home, consider this our welcoming gift.
It would seem we are trapped.
And the only way out is through Ultima. We find him, and we leave.
If you are to comprehend the full extent of your transgressions, we must go back to the beginning. When the world was still young, we visited upon it a miracle, magic, and in its light did all life flourish. Yet the price for this boon would prove heavy. A pall descended upon the land, painting the horizon black as night. Though we labored to forestall its spread, in this one endeavor, we stood powerless. And so we fled, that we might endure. Endure, that we might discover a means of salvation.
But if it was magic that caused the blight, what of the mother crystals?
I expect he'll tell us soon enough.
Salvation, alas, was not readily to be had. First, we would require a land unvisited by the stain of corruption. An unprecedented journey lay before us, one beyond the limits of our fleshly bodies, and so we cast them off. Thus stripped to our very spirit, did we find our new paradise. A land as pure as driven snow. Valisthea. There would the true work begin. For the black crept yet behind us. And soon did we arrive at a solution. The illness having spread to every organ. There was but one escape from this fate. To start afresh.
With a new world. The one for which Barnabas labored. A paradise free from the blight where his God awaits. And where, if we only forfeit our wills and abandon everything we hold dear, humanity can join him. So, Ultima would have us follow in the footsteps of the king.
And follow we shall. For now.
So blind to his own hypocrisy.
Not blind, just unwilling to admit the truth. But we're one and the same.
freed, or what's left of him.
Long have our ashes lain cold for want of a spark. Cast your eyes upon them and see what you must become. Valisthea cannot endure a second claim upon her being. The avarice of man drives her ever closer to destruction. But she may yet be saved by you. It is what you were born to do. Why we nursed you and fed you. As your own mother should have. And now that you are fully grown, our Muthos, it is time at last for you to serve your purpose.
To right your wrongs. If our sin is wanting to survive, then you are as marked by it as we are. The fault is yours. Our wills were born because you abandoned us. And now, you would have us forfeit them. All for a place in your new paradise.
Do you imagine yourselves worthy of one? Mankind has no place in our world. Is this truly so difficult to comprehend? We only ever require you, Muthos, when the time comes to bid this wretched realm farewell. None shall follow, none shall remain.
What do you mean, none?
This is our world. Once the land's rebirth is complete, humanity will have served its purpose. Why would we continue to suffer that which has caused us so much vexation?
Because the land doesn't belong to you. It belongs to us all!
What?
That is where you are mistaken. You own nothing but your precious will.
Brother.
I can't do this alone.
And you don't have to.
I grow weary of your descent. Now you must learn that this master will not tolerate disobedience.
My friends, my family, we have all suffered, all fought to survive. This world may be flawed. It may be broken. But it's all we have. And if we can't share it, I see only one other choice. You have to go.
You may have created us, Ultima. It's time we lived on our own terms. This isn't your world anymore. It's us.
Bow down, offenders, hearts disdained.
Slow.
Ah!
sublimed through gainstanding. Only with heads hung low is penance paid. Oh, wretched mortals, incapable even of contrition. In fitting season shall we reap our harvest. Gifted this chance, and still you would raise your hand against the Lord.
What now? The darkness bends. He means to end us.
It wouldn't be the first time. But let's make it his last.
Your fate is inexorable. Surrender the vessel unto the darkness. Surrender it unto us. Kneel before us. countless generations have we awaited this moment. Your struggles have made you strong, yet your soul remains heavy with sin. Absolution is nigh. Repent, and all shall be forgiven.
Tell me, Clive, how many lives have you saved since taking my name?
Fewer than we have ruined. Wherever we go, we leave a sea of tears in our wake.
These are the wages of your will, son.
What good are our choices when all they ever bring, all they will ever bring, is death?
There's no atoning, Clive. No matter how hard you try.
So why not leave it all behind?
Leave it all behind.
Somebody save me. Won't anybody love me?
I yearn, yet still she is not mine. Have I not given enough?
From will is born desire, and it is this which consumes you, rendering you incomplete.
Do you not see how the world bends and warps under the weight of your hungering hearts? What if it could all just go away? Just go away.
None of this is real. Wake up. It's time to go home, Clive.
Clive.
That's right. You're my brother.
Brother?
Remember who you are.
Clive.
Once more, lest you forget.
My name is Clive. Clive Rossfield.
Look,
Ultima.
Even here, the light of the vessel's will cannot be quenched. And the Phoenix, his trespass should not have been possible. Not possible unless... unless he has been with Muthos all along. The mark of the Phoenix, emblazoned upon his heart, made manifest by the power of will alone. The power of creation. Can it be? Are their wills truly so potent?
Are you still talking?
Sorry to wake you, but I think it may be time to leave this place.
And once again, does my creation stray from the path laid before it? Steeped in conceit, you fancy yourself a god. You embrace Logos. But we will put an end to this hubris.
What are you talking about?
In the halls of origin, does our true power quicken? And there shall you be made complete. Soon, Muthos, soon you will discover how little you know of suffering.
Thank you.
And so the crystals are no more. Yet in their silence, a new song rings. Its chorus building. A crescendo as it enters its final movement. Stirring those long aslumber to waking. And back to their origin.
Bloody crystals cracked. So where the hell are they? Oh, fuck me.
Is that ether?
What in good Grieger's name is going on?
This is wrong.
Are we back?
Clive! Joshua!
Jill! Is everyone all right?
We're fine. What happened?
Too much to explain here.
Mate! We're leaving! Now! Everyone, fall back to the ship!
I will be with you anon.
Thank you.
Tell everyone what happened to Drake's spine, and I'm going to need Otto's help.
Do
Did you know that it was I who convinced His Imperial Highness to join you in Stonehear? All right, it may be that he was of a mind to do so already, but it was I who told him where you'd be.
It's not often our entire merry flock returns home to roost at once. I expect I should be wishing you good luck.
There's something about it. I feel like it's calling to me.
Origin, he called it. The origin of what?
Is it? It's the end, is what it is.
I have wronged so many. Ruined thousands of lives. I did not deserve to be saved. But save me, you and your brother did. Your uncle, too, forgave me my sins. Offered me a chance at redemption. Yours is a fine family, Ifrit. Cherish it.
About. The odor's what gives chances to its, depth. And that's what makes it superior to any old lizard livers.
Oh, please. Have you even tried the fried mortress? Taste, smell, texture. It beats your beloved stew hands down on every count. Now that's a masterpiece.
Gonna deal with that. What do you think that thing is?
It's a damn distraction, is what it is. Now back to work.
Don't you worry, Sid. I'll still take you anywhere you want, provided it's away from that bleeding eyesore.
Like a fuck-off crystal hanging over the horizon to sour your ale.
Is this the last of the Mother Crystals, do you think? Or could there be others buried out there?
Sid, did you know that chocobos are far more resilient to the effects of ether than most other beasts? Some say that's one of the reasons they were tamed for use as mounts and sumpters, so that an ether flood wouldn't mean instant death for their riders or drivers. Me, I reckon they built it up over generations.
Neither.
Good morrow to you, my friend. I don't believe you've read this particular chapter before. If you have a question for me, I should be happy to answer it. Did you learn everything you needed?
Still alive, are you? If you're gonna buy something, be quick about it. It'd better all be here. You're rubbing me blind, you know. It'd better all be here. You'll not find a better price than that. Finished, are you?
First the skies, then the crystal. What next? The advent of Great Grieger herself. I'm sure we'll be fine. Sid's back, isn't he?
What do I owe the honor? What do you want? You can thank me later. Yeah, that should do you. Thank me later. Do my best work, but it'll do. Yeah, that should do you. You can thank me later. Anything else?
I did it, Sid. I made friends with all the animals in the hideaway. But you know what I'd really like? My own goblin. Or maybe a morble or a bomb. But only if it was a big one. That or a bander curl, but not a cactuar. They're too prickly.
Say what you will. Lady Karen has seen our shelves haven't gone bare.
Yes, but how long will it last?
This should tide us over until the new moon.
You needn't worry about the backyard, Sid. We're here, so you don't have to be.
Drink up, my little darlings.
A few more of these, and the Deadlands will seem less dead.
These flowers are beautiful. What do we have to boil them all down to make medicine?
These leaves should have withered long ago.
We found a way. Life has found a way.
I'll see that you're properly watered and manured, Martel. For as long as I'm able.
Whatever should I write next?
Miss Shirley!
A love story, perhaps? But with a happy ending, of course.
That's very nice, Jocelyn. But perhaps you could start with your sums?
If you need the Enterprise, just say the word. As long as the word isn't fly. She can't do that. Yet.
That crystal certainly don't bode well. But just think of all the secrets it must hold. Here. If you're planning on going up there, you could bring a bit back for me, could you?
Suppose it's magic keeping the thing afloat.
What else could it be?
So there's
one another. Moment you think you've freed the realm from her fate. The next, a darker one rears up to replace it. What awaits us when we finally attain release? True freedom? Or something else entirely?
My heart has wandered hither and thither in search of the perfect companion. When all along he was here, standing right beside me. All this time, my heart has wandered hither.
It couldn't have been easy for her making the journey from Ash. What with her belly so fat?
You'd be surprised at the lengths a mother is willing to go for her child.
These skies are taking their toll on the hideaway, Clive. I can mend a broken arm, but a broken spirit is beyond my talents.
Tie his tea, stop the fits. I only hope this stays stopped.
Thank you, my lord, for taking me in. Everyone here has been so kind. It reminds me of home.
Twin sides hundreds of leagues away. That'd mean the crystal is
massive.
What is it that you wish to learn? I have the details here. Here you are. Good.
Still alive, I see. Something tells me that I saw on the horizon is your doing. How'd you manage that?
It's a long story. One that I'd rather only tell once.
Right. All hands on deck, then.
I'm sure you've all guessed. The crystal which now commands the eastern skies was summoned by Ultima. He called it Origin. Though the significance of that name is as yet unclear.
What does it matter what it's called? Its emergence tore Twinside asunder and wiped my homeland from the map.
Mention of the Dominion spires can be found in the oldest of Valisthian records. But to the best of my knowledge, none provide any hint as to their true nature. That they would prove the horns of some slumbering demon. Well,
the Dominion's demise was at least quick. Elsewhere, the Republican army cannot hope to contain the chaos engulfing Randalar. Canva is in flames, and the Empire.
Our allies are crying out for answers. I've sent the Cursebreakers to give them what assurances we can, but right now that amounts to fuck all.
They wouldn't be able to stop what the skies have started in any case. People here and across the realm grow sicker with every passing day.
Could it be that this new Mother Crystal is like the others? That it draws upon the land's ether? Certainly looked that way from stone here.
If that were true, it would explain the hastening spread of the blight since the crystal's appearance, would it not?
And as the land's ether slowly rises to the surface, it pools, corrupting all who cannot channel its energies. Arcay above, ether floods below, and in the middle, here we languish, hopelessly entrapped.
It's all right.
When we faced him at Stonehere, Ultima told us his true power quickens in the halls of Origin. Needless to say, we cannot allow that to continue. If we are to stop him, we will have to find a way into the crystal.
How are we going to manage that then? It's up in the sky. And fast as she is, the Enterprise can't fly.
It's a lot to take in, and I reckon we'd all benefit from some time to clear our heads. The answer will come to us. Don't you worry. Ain't that right, Clive?
Right. That's right.
Well, go on then. Bugger off. Same goes for you, Clive. You won't solve anything like this. Trust me. Go and get some fresh air, eh?
Thank you. Joshua seemed upset.
Unless you've taught our chocobos how to fly, I won't be scouting this one for you, Clive. You're on your own, but not alone.
Always one more job to do, isn't there, Clive?
There is much to consider.
Believe me, Clive, I would fly with you to Origin, nay, to the end of the world, if I could. Alas, my fear of heights prevents me.
You're going somewhere, Sid? Can we come? I promise we'll be good.
I was wondering when next you'd visit. Fare thee well, my friend.
Do you think they'll come back?
Of course they will. It's just a big crystal. How hard could it be?
You be careful up there. But if you happen to snag your britches on anything, be sure to bring them back to me. I'll get them patched up right away.
Inside's hundreds of leagues away. Better mean the crystal is
massive. Take as long as you need, Clive. Just don't take too long, eh?
What will it be today?
How may I help you today?
Here you are. The state of the realm is ever-changing, Clive.
You nearly collapsed back there.
It's just a touch of the vapors. I'll be fine.
Ties tea stop the fits. I only hope
until the skies
stop.
Have cleared, more and more will fall to its curse. I will do what I can, but...
Thank you, my lord, for taking me in.
First be filled to bring one joy.
All this time, my heart has wandered.
Has Midadol mentioned a new project yet?
Not exactly. She seems preoccupied, but then again, when isn't she?
I'd give anything to follow you up there to that crystal. Give me a few more years and I might even be able to take you there myself.
That crystal certainly don't bode well.
Do you suppose it's magic keeping the thing afloat?
So there's a new mother. Fussing over it.
Do you think Sid'll tell us about
his
adventures in
Ash? Shirley says your books made quite an impression on the children.
I heard he's leaving again.
Inspired them all to become writers.
Well, maybe when he gets back.
Is that so? We'll need to find some more parchment then.
When you return, would you mind teaching the children another lesson? They did so enjoy your last.
Say what you will. Lady Karen has seen our shelves haven't gone.
You needn't worry about the backyard, Sid. We're here, so you don't have to be.
Drink up, my little darlings.
Without sun, these leaves should have withered long ago.
But we've found a way.
First the skies, then the crystal.
I will not forget this kindness, my lord. I shall go to
but as soon as the rebuilding work is complete.
this origin is a mother crystal, it must be destroyed like all the rest. We've come too far to give up now.
Ultima may have created us, but he doesn't make us who we are. Only we can do that. And if he would have us fight for our survival, so be it. It's what we've been doing all along.
Much like Ultima himself, it would seem. His new world being naught but a means to survive. And so, we must contend to decide which of us shall inherit the land. Should Ultima prevail, it will mean death for us all. Of that, we can be certain. But even should he fail, what world awaits us? A withered, godless place, where our newfound freedom will most like prove a chain in itself.
Well, that may be, but a chain can always be broken. As long as one has the will to break it, it won't be easy. It may take generations, centuries of suffering. And that is if everyone plays their part. But it will happen. And when it does, it will be on our terms. That is the world that awaits us.
Indeed. And what better world could one wish for?
But first, we have to reach that crystal.
Then it's a good thing I have wings.
You can barely stand, let alone fly. And only the Founder knows what horrors await in those skies. You certain about this?
Am I certain? I am the Phoenix. I will do what I must. This is our fight. Remember?
All right. I yield. But only what you must, yes? I'm still your sworn shield.
That you are.
And what of my wings? Lest you forget, you go to stand against a god. I would not have you succumb to fatigue before the fight begins. Ifrit. Your brother mentioned that some few of the dominants who had lost their power to you were still able to prime. Is that true?
It is. But their icons no longer submitted to their will.
Then mine will have to be stronger. That you both might save your strength for the battle to come.
You don't have to do this.
If you do, there's a chance you might lose all you have left.
And what have I but regret? My life ended in the Dominion. I fear death no more. Besides, I would have words with Ultima. He has much to answer for.
We are in your debt, Dion.
We can speak of debts when this is over.
He speaks like a man who knows he's not coming back. And has come to terms with that.
That doesn't mean that we have to. Does it, Clive?
Time to talk to Jill. I only hope she understands.
Take as much time as you need, brother. Something tells me Ultima will wait.
Say your farewells, and let us be gone.
Unless you've taught our chocobos how to fly.
Come to wish on a star.
Be such a bad idea. This is it, Jill. You know what I have to do? Why I have to do it? There's no turning back now. This is where our journey was leading us. Where it will end, for better or worse.
I could pray to Metia for you. But you'll be all right, won't you, Clive? You always are.
I did promise we'd watch the moon together.
I'll be waiting.
Sure, I haven't forgotten anything.
Clive, do you have a moment?
Of course. Always.
I wanted to give you something.
Is this?
I stitched it from the cloth you gave Hortense, the piece she said you liked best. I told her I used to enjoy needlework, but I didn't think she'd remember.
It's beautiful, Jill. You didn't have to.
When I was very little, I recall my mother telling me that young ladies of the court would give knights ribbons from their hair before they went off to war. I still wear mine, so I made you this instead. White is the color of faith. Faith in your friends, your family, your purpose. Unblemished, unfeigned. Just like my faith in you.
Our faith. May it ever steer us true.
And may it ever bring you back to me. I will always, always be here.
Thank you, Jill.
It's not time yet, is it? Somewhere in the back of my mind. I know. Thank you. And so for now? Right.
What is it this time, Torgul? Something tells me this is no mere adventure story.
You're right. About that. Oi! Let's see. You off then?
It's him, I tell you! The Crown Prince of Sambrek! Though I suppose he's the Emperor now.
The Emperor? Here in our hideaway?
Now don't mind him. I believe him.
Thank you, Uncle.
As for down here... Clive, my boy! Rutherford informs me that we owe you our thanks. Hadn't intended for you to get involved, but such are the times we live in, huh?
I would have done the same for anyone else.
You're far too modest, Clive. You'd make a terrible nobleman. But tell me, is the realm truly in as dire a state as Rutherford suggests?
From what little I saw, you were right to be worried.
I suppose I should have expected the worst. But I was rather hoping the great and good of the realm might have things a little more under control. Alas, it seems that firm leadership is in short supply these days, and without it, the people are bound to lose their way. We must move quickly.
But where do we start?
True, the challenges that face us are many. But in my estimation, there are two key areas to be addressed before any other. The realm's armies and her larders. As you've seen firsthand, it's every man and woman for themselves out there. Certain cities have banded together to try and maintain some semblance of order, yes? But such cases are few and far between. And yet, the only remedy for the chaos that faces us is unity. A unity that transcends even the borders laid down by our ancestors. In short, if Storm does not stand together, she will fall apart.
But how would one even begin to unite the realm?
The armies, my boy. As I told you already, we begin by restoring order among the ranks of those sworn to maintain it. Sadly, I doubt I could convince even the lowliest gaggle of privates to dig a latrine together. But I do know someone the High Commanders have been known to listen to on occasion. Field Marshal Eugen Havel.
I thought he was retired.
He was, until an Akashic army tore through Randalar and killed most of the rank and file. There is no man alive more capable. Literally. And as luck would have it, I've already spoken with him on the matter.
Of course you have.
And he's agreed to help. On one condition. That he first speaks with you personally. Havel has always been a man of frustratingly rigid principle. And he has certain qualms about clasping arms with... Well... with an outlaw.
I extolled your many virtues as best I could, of course, but the old goat was adamant that he be allowed to appraise you in person. You don't mind, do you, my boy?
Of course not. As long as chaos reigns, we will never build a better world. I'll do whatever it takes. And if the Field Marshal wishes to speak with me in person, then so be it.
That's the spirit.
I'll leave for Randalar at once. Would you send a Stolas?
Of course. Rutherford is already in the Dalmechian capital. I'll have him tell Havel to expect you forthwith.
Excellent. Thank you, Uncle.
No. Thank you, Clive. Don't worry, my boy. Rutherford is in Randalar this very moment, singing your praises to all and sundry. They'll adore you.
Is there all you need?
It's hardly everything.
And a will! I promise! You can count on me! Be careful out there!
I did it, Sid! I made friends with all the animals!
Say what you will. Ready to see us.
Pining for something, boy. What is it? What do you see out there? I never did ask where you got that anklet of yours.
From Sid, that's why. On the day brought him home.
That long ago.
And you're only thinking to ask this now? Sid saw that the pup had a habit of gnawing on his leg, since you ask. Clap that there iron on him to keep him from doing it.
What was wrong, boy?
I'll take like as not. Must have been hard on the poor whelp losing his loving masters at such a young age. Doubly hard in being a frost wolf, torn away from his icons and all. Sid would always tell him, you want that iron gone, you find what it is you're looking for. I reckon what he was looking for was you.
I'm sorry, Torgo. Sorry for making you wait so long. Let's get that thing off you.
Doesn't sound like he wants it off.
Indeed. You miss it as much as the rest of us, don't you? You want me to go with you somewhere?
Quick, aren't you? Glad you've been paying attention.
Not nearly as much as you have, Lady Karen.
Aye, good thing and all. It's not like Gav would have kept him in nuts and rummed his belly these past 10 summers.
Your kindness is appreciated. You've been a good friend to him.
Only because he doesn't talk back like the rest of you. Go on now.
Where to then, Torgal? All right, Torgal. Where are you taking me? I'm going to need a little bit more than that, boy. Do you have a better hint for me? Unless... you've already given me one. Back on the rear deck, you were looking west. Toward Rosaria. Why don't we try the rookery? I haven't been to the island in almost 20 years. Deport is older then. Fingers crossed the old mooring is still there.
Be time to take a step back. But if it weren't for Sid, I know you'll do right by us, Clive.
Vivian, I read your note. And I'd be happy to help you find the book you're looking for.
Thank you, Clive. But tracking it down will not be easy. Are you sure?
Please. You have always granted me your wisdom and insight whenever I asked. It's only right that I return the favor. Or at least attempt to.
You are too kind. Alas, what I ask of you is rather more trying than delivering the odd lecture. I spoke with Harpocrates to see if he had any inkling as to where another copy might be found, but... But perhaps it is best that you hear the details from him.
If you say so.
Forgive me, Clive, for asking this of you. But this book, it set me on the path to becoming who I am today. Its importance cannot be overstated. Back again? Well, Clive?
I am.
Naturally. I shall... Harpocrates knows of the tome I seek. Whether what he has to say makes you happy to have agreed to help me is another matter. I do so enjoy our little chats.
My boy, what a pleasure it is to see you.
Harpocrates, there's something I need to ask you. I've been charged with locating a book called From a Distance.
Then you seek a rare gem indeed. One whose name I had not thought to hear from your lips. You've been talking to Vivian.
Right as always. But she didn't seem keen to tell me very much. I take it she didn't like what you had to say.
And yet I gather it did naught to dissuade her. Clive, if the young professor has tasked you with obtaining a copy, I fear she asks the impossible. The executors would not allow it.
The executors?
Coveters of Secrets. A clandestine organization committed to the collection and intenebration of forbidden texts and technologies. One such text being the tome Vivian seeks, chronicling as it does the true history of the enslavement of bearers, a tale which could overturn the established order were it ever to become widely known, or So rumor has it. I've never actually read the thing, or even set eyes on it for that matter.
How is it that I haven't heard of this organization?
Why, secrecy is the Executor's watchword. They lurk in the shadows, emerging only to seize that which must be seized, be it books, inventions, or people, before disappearing again, leaving nary a trace.
Which would explain why Vivian's copy was snatched from her grasp not long after she found it.
By the hand of the Executors, yes.
But what drives them? Self-interest or ideology?
Fine question. Sadly, all that is known of the Executors can be recounted in a single breath. You may just as soon ask me of their origins, numbers, or the identities of their leaders. Any answer I give would be pure speculation.
Then my hunt was doomed from the first. What was Vivian expecting? That I'd pluck it from thin air?
Not from thin air, no. From ash. Rumors of the Executors are rife among the Scholars of Storm, but rather less so across the Strait. I have a friend. Well, I had a friend in the village of Garnick, a collector of rare tomes, upon which subject we would oft correspond. Alas, I have heard naught from him since the skies fell dark. And no doubt he, too, has turned. But though he did not mention it by name, it is possible that a surviving copy of From a Distance yet rests upon one of his many shelves, quietly awaiting discovery. If you were, by some chance, able to save even a single book from the poor man's library, I know his soul would rest easier.
Very well. When I next find myself in Walud, I'll be sure to pay Garnick a visit.
Good morrow to you, my friend. Ah, yes. Indeed. Then go. Having never visited, I cannot tell you exactly where in Garnick my friend's lodgings lie, but he did mention they were some distance from the road. I make no guarantee that you will find what you seek there, only that it is the best and perhaps the only place left to look. Thank you for indulging an old man.
It's still here, after all these years. Lots smaller than I remember. And you're a lot bigger. You might have to swim, boy. I wasn't being serious. This place hasn't changed at all. The rookery's right through those trees. Come on. Race you there? I bet I can still beat you. Here we are. This was our hideaway. Wasn't it, Torkoal? Coming here helped me to forget who I was. Or wasn't. Prince. Shield. Son his mother could love. Had I been any one of those things? Perhaps. What is it, boy? This is all from the castle. And Phoenix Gate. Did you bring these here? My sparring sword. Well, well. You never stopped looking for me, did you, boy? Thank you, Torkoal. For never giving up. For never forgetting. Let's take this with us, shall we? So I don't forget either. That's not the way back to the boat, Torkoal. All right, I'm coming. I think I know where we're going. People always talk about the importance of putting the past behind you. But without it, we wouldn't be who we are today. And we certainly couldn't steer our way to a better tomorrow. Come on, Torkoal. Let's go home.
I've never seen Myself cry before.
Is Theo really gone then?
Good day, Clive. When we fled our childhood home, I loved him. Did I tell you? That was what he wanted. No matter how hard it might be. The Dominion has fallen. The Crimson Caravans must set an example. It is our job to keep the hope alive. Come back soon, won't you?
What are you looking for?
A discerning eye.
Do you see that too?
There are many variations of the Samekian legend, but almost all agree that man was punished for presuming to set foot in the sanctum of the gods. Some describe it as holy, others heavenly, which is to say, of the heavens. Could it be that the baleful mass that now glowers over us is this very sanctum? Have the gods returned to pass judgment upon us once more?
It's not real. It can't be. I'm seeing things.
Papa? What keeps it in the air? Why doesn't it fall?
Don't you go tempting fate, girl.
What is it?
Don't ask me.
Oh, please. Just make it stop. Make it stop.
I'm scared.
It's all right. I'm here.
Nothing good's gonna come of this, I'm telling you.
Just looking at it's enough to send a shiver down your spine.
Come on.
Run like the wind.
Turncoats and cowards, the lot of you! If it's a fight you want, it's a fight you shall have!
Allow me.
I don't need your...
Please, Field Marshal, oblige him. This won't take long.
You're right. It won't. Men, finish him.
A little longer than I'd have liked. Field Marshal Havel, I presume. Are either of you injured?
No, my lord. You arrived just as our escort turned on us.
Fucking traitors! I'd heard reports of soldiers in the outlying regions abandoning the oaths they swore. But I hadn't thought the corruption had reached so close to the heart of the Republic. It's a fucking disgrace. Your interfering old bastard of an uncle tried to warn me, of course. My lord, Marquis. Or is Sid the Outlaw more to your liking?
Call me what you want. It doesn't change who I am. Or the urgency of the message I bring. My uncle has a plan to right the realm, and he needs your help to see it through.
Before I agree to anything, I'd have you answer one question. What do you stand to gain from all this?
I won't deny that I might benefit from further chaos. But I seek a new beginning for all of us. And while the choices I've made may not always have been the right ones, I know I made them for the right reasons. For so long, so many of us have been told how we could live, how we could die, when it should have been our decision all along. Now we have a chance to put things right. But in order to take it, we must stand together. Even if it be beside those with whom we don't see eye to eye.
Certainly not the words I expected from an outlaw. But perhaps your uncle was right. You are no ordinary outlaw. I'll never hear the end of this. All right. I'll start by ordering my most trusted guard to bring the Dalmechian fringes under control. Next, I'll make contact with my counterparts in the Imperial Army and see if I can't convince them to try and restore order in their own territory.
Thank you, Field Marshal.
But they are not the only ones we will need to convince.
What do you mean?
I don't doubt that I can bully some sense into a few generals. But those they answer to require a different kind of persuasion. And when it comes to honeyed words, well, we will need an envoy. One who can court even the most stubborn of statesmen. You, perhaps.
I'm flattered. But I'm no diplomat either. And I have other problems to attend to. What we need is a skilled arbitrator. And I may know just the person.
Is that so? And would he happen to be an outlaw, too?
Of a different kind, perhaps.
Well, beggars can't be choosers. I suppose we'll all have to find a little of the outlaw in ourselves if we're to make it through this. Very well. Send your man to me right away.
I shall.
My Lord Marquis. Your lord uncle bade me escort the Field Marshal to his manor in Port Isolde.
And I will see that my associate joins you there.
Very good, my lord.
Huh. An envoy. I'm not sure I'm the man to talk anyone round. I can barely convince my brother to take his medicine. No. This is a job for someone with experience. Someone like Quentin. I hope I can convince him at least.
Quentin's gonna build us new Lost Wing, and I'm gonna help.
We may be bruised, we may be battered.
I'd have followed Quentin to that manor if I could have done. But I'll keep following him now. Wherever that surly bastard cares to lead us.
Quentin, I have a proposal for you.
Do you now? Something tells me you'll be asking more of me than a cask of Gotand gold. Go on, then. Propose. You'd have me convince the chiefs and chamberlains of the realm that they should simply swallow their pride and do the one thing that has proved impossible for thousands of years. Was there anything else? Perhaps I can fetch you a meat pie as well.
I know it's a lot to ask, but I can think of none better suited to the role.
And you'd have me give up what little I have left to do it. I told you, Clive. The people of Lostwing are my family, and I cannot abandon them. You'll have to find someone else.
I'm sorry to hear that.
So am I.
And why might that be?
What he's asking. How's it any different to what you've done so far? They want you to speak for those who can't speak for themselves. That's what you do best. If it's the vineyard you're worried about, we'll see that the grapes are picked and the tons filled. You know we will.
It's not that.
Then what is it? You said yourself we're family. Don't you trust us?
You know that's not what I'm...
Then what are you saying? That only we are worth saving? Why turn your back on everyone else? You convinced us we could build new lives for ourselves, and if you can do that, who's to say you couldn't convince the entire realm?
A stirring argument. I fear that any rejoinder I make might fall somewhat flat by comparison.
So you'll join us?
Where do you need me?
Field Marshal Havel will want to speak with you in person. He's currently in Port Isolde. I can arrange for a party of Cursebreakers to accompany you there.
That would be very much appreciated. I hear the roads are far from safe these days.
Hopefully not for long. My uncle will want to know that his plan is taking shape.
Any statesmen we speak with are liable to resist our entreaties if they feel that what little power remains to them is at stake. They must be dealt with skillfully. I shall not repeat the errors of my past.
Reckon Master Quentin could argue an egg back up a hen's quim if he set his mind to it.
The entire village looks abandoned. Now, which house would a bookworm live in? Interests were certainly varied. This is a Royal Army logbook. Did he take this from the local barracks? This is it. But if what it says is true, I need to get this back to the hideaway.
Leaving so soon, stranger. Been watching you from a distance, so to speak.
Subtle. I know who you are.
Then we need not waste time on introductions. Hand me the book. Leave it in our care and return to your life.
Your care? Do you mean to burn it or bury it?
That is not my decision to make, but by one means or another, its contents shall be removed from the common record.
Then I'll have to politely refuse. I won't let you erase our history.
Then we find ourselves at an impasse. Very well. The book can just as easily be pried from your dead hand.
Let's see, shall we?
Come on.
Impressive. But we have other means. We shall claim the book yet.
Why do you want it so badly anyway?
It lays out in no uncertain terms the vanity and avarice of mankind. It tells the shameful history of the persecution and oppression of a gifted few by a giftless many. Would you say that this interpretation was correct?
I don't know.
You don't know? Your sword may be sharp, but your wits are dull. So let me answer for you. There is no correct interpretation of history. That a series of events took place may be proved beyond a doubt. But there can be no single, immutable explanation as to why they came to pass. It is a question of numbers and of belief. If enough people believe that a set of events occurred for a reason, that belief becomes the truth.
So you're trying to control the truth?
We are trying to protect people from themselves, from knowledge that would bring them naught but pain. That is all. You may keep the book for now. The world is small. We shall meet again. Until then.
Wait! Let's get this back to Vivian. Perhaps she can explain what that was all about.
Uncle, I bring good news. The Field Marshal has agreed to your plan.
Ha! Of course he has! I didn't doubt you for a moment, dear boy.
Rutherford is accompanying him back to your manor in Port Isolde as we speak. They will await your return there. As will one other.
One other? Who, exactly?
Lord Havel was concerned that even if he could get the realm's armies to agree to an accord, he might not be as successful in convincing those with political power. He asked if I might have a solution. And I suggested a certain Imperial Lord Magistrate turned Liberator.
One of your co-conspirators?
Master Quinton would probably call me one of his. But yes.
Another outlaw, then? Just the thing we need to put these rotten politicos in their places. Good thinking, Clive.
I'm glad you approve.
The more the merrier, eh?
Uncle, assuming Havel and Quinton can solve our problem with the armies, you still haven't mentioned how we might manage the grain shortages.
Oh, don't you worry, my boy. The seven high houses will be seeing to that. They have all agreed to make the most generous of donations. Of course, it did take a little persuasion. But luckily I had some unexpected help.
From who?
Why, you, my boy. Rumor has it that you rescued the Lady Ariane's head steward, Rockford, from a horde of bloodthirsty bandits.
It was more of a handful.
Well, the old battleaxe was so pleased. She had a shipload of talents delivered to my private docks by the next new moon. And when the other houses saw the parsimonious old crone's purse strings finally loosen, they as good as tripped over themselves in the rush to follow suit.
I'm happy to hear it.
Now, I must be getting back to the manor. Join us there at your earliest convenience, would you?
Of course, Uncle.
And how, pray tell, will we get that grain to the capital if the roads are still overrun with Akashic?
You'll find another bloody road. I only have so many men, and I'm not about to send them headlong into an ether flood. That is, unless you'd have them turn as well.
Well, I'd certainly eat less.
Says the man with a belly bigger than a band of curls. My soldiers actually need their rations. Without any food to keep them going, they'll be dead even before you've sent them on your fool's errand.
If I may, gentlemen, perhaps I might suggest an alternative approach. Though supply routes are indeed disrupted, there is no shortage of ships. Indeed, they bob away in every bay from here to Randalar, awaiting a safe haven. Allow them to make port and fill their bellies full of grain. And once those who crowd the cities are fed, ferry the displaced back to the countryside to work the fallow fields. Ah, but I'm sure that you wish to continue your discussion. Forgive the interruption. Two such firm friends as yourselves need no help from the likes of me. Rutherford spoke fondly of the great bond between you.
Us? Friends?
I can't stand the man!
Clive, I'm beginning to question the quality of the company you keep.
And what kind of company were you expecting him to keep? The man's a criminal!
Criminal? How dare you? You are not fit to breathe the same air as this fine, upstanding young gentleman.
Upstanding? He calls himself Sid the Bloody Outlaw.
Once more unto the breach.
Shall we begin again? What we seek here is not to create a new nation, nor to claim the thrones of those that already exist. We wish simply to bring stability to the realm that mankind might weather the current storm. And to do that, we must convince those in power, the generals, the statesmen, the nobles, that our cause is just. There will be disagreements, yes. And I imagine some resistance, much resistance. But we cannot let that deter us. If we show them the path, show them that we walk it ourselves, then I am confident they will follow. The fate of the world lies in my nephew's hands, but the well-being of her people lies in ours. And we must not squander the chance that Clive has given us.
Uncle Byron, aye.
Now, with that settled, let's move on to the signing of the accord. For what great moment in history hasn't been accompanied by a little ceremony? Citizens of Valisthea, I present to you the Triunity, Rutherford, Mike Will. Well, my boy, the stage is set.
That it is.
This is the role you were born for. Now I ask only that you trust in the talents of your supporting cast. We shall play our parts to the best of our abilities, that you might have the opportunity to shine. The realm needs its Sir Crandall. And there is no better Crandall than you, Clive. I want you to keep this signed accord as proof of our faith in you.
I will. Thank you, Uncle.
Sorry. Can't take you where you need to get to.
What do you think that thing is?
Must we away? My decision is made. You said it yourself. He must be stopped.
He must.
I await your word.
There's something about it.
Vivian. I found it. The book you lost.
You found it.
Thank you, Clive. Even though I asked this of you, I was not entirely sure it would be possible. I feared the executors had seized every copy.
I met with one of these executors, and I convinced him to let me keep it. He told me something. That the truth is just a matter of collective belief, and that if enough people believe a lie, that lie becomes the truth.
It does. But it also means that the truth is not immutable. That it can be changed. Provided that those who wish to change it can convince enough people that their perspective is the correct one. As the sad history of the bearers proves.
You said that the book inspired you to become a scholar.
It did. Or its author, rather. She was a heretic, you see. A firebrand and a dissenter. A gallows stood ready for her in every corner of the realm. And by shunning society, or perhaps being shunned by it, she stumbled upon a truth so potent that an entire realm trembled at the prospect of its utterance. I, too, have always felt somehow set apart from the world of men. A stranger to my own species. She taught me that my solitude was not a curse, but a gift. And that, though my journey to the truth might be a lonely one, what I found at my destination would be more than worth the cost.
Do you still feel that way? That you're not one of us?
Honestly? I'm not entirely sure anymore. Since coming to the hideaway, I find my thinking somewhat clouded. Perhaps the result of studying mankind from a rather closer perspective than I had intended. But the more I study, the more I find value in this perspective. In looking not from the outside, but from within. So if you'll permit me, I'd like to continue my work here. Remember, Clive, when enough people believe, belief begets truth. Give the men and women of this benighted world the gift of truth. Make them believe in you, as I do.
I'll try, Vivian. I'll try.
Thank you.
Clive. And no sooner have your wounds mended. While I may not have Gav's nose, that's what I'm worried about.
I do.
What I truly like would teach her medicine. Take care.
Thank you, my lord, for taking me in.
Is there aught I might assist you with? My lord.
I am.
I do not doubt it.
Thank you, Yote.
May you return safely. I prithee, do not risk yourself unduly.
You nearly collapsed back there.
He's just papers.
Sid, may I have a moment?
Of course.
It is an honor to finally speak with you. My name is Herman. I've been with the Cursebreakers for some time now, and I wish to be deployed to Ash. Any assignment will do.
No. The lands across the Narrow are too dangerous. I will not send good men and women to risk their lives needlessly. Why would you want to go back?
I need to retrieve something. Something important. I was raised in an orphanage. The Badbach Conservatory. Or rather, I was held captive there. It was not a place of nurture. It existed solely to turn bearer children into mindless weapons. We were tortured until we feared no pain. Tormented until our hearts turned to stone, and few ever survived long enough to become tools of the last king.
I can't imagine.
I lost so many. I can't even remember all their names, but they must be remembered. They cannot fade away, faceless and forgotten. The Institute was run with military precision. Every child measured, every name recorded, every death logged with meticulous care. Sid, allow me to travel to Ash and recover the registry so that my brothers and sisters might live on.
You are a good friend, Herman. But the fact remains that Ash is simply too dangerous.
Sid, please. Even should it cost me my life.
Too dangerous for you, Herman. But not for me. I'll go to Badbach and find the registry.
You will?
I won't let you risk your life.
I don't know how to thank you.
You can start by telling me where I'll find this orphanage.
Vida Grace. Hidden in a forest, overlooking the plains.
All right. I'll see what I can find there.
May the mothers guide you. The plains of Vida Grace have haunted my dreams since I escaped from the orphanage. I can't say I was looking forward to returning.
Do you suppose it's magic keeping
the soul? One moment, you think you've freed the realm from her fate. The next, a darker one rears up to replace it. What awaits us when we finally attain release? True freedom? Or something else entirely?
Something.
Make a name for yourself.
You better bloody I'd do and all. Draw, Clive.
What do you think happened to Miss Mid at all? I heard she was kicked out of the university.
When you return, would you mind teaching the children another lesson? They did so enjoy your last.
Become writers themselves. Is that so?
We'll need to find some more parchments then.
Sid, you have to help us.
With what? You didn't take apart another of Mid's contraptions, did you?
No. Well, yes. But that's not what we want to talk to you about.
It's Miss Mid at all. She's been acting strange.
Very strange. She's barely ever around.
When she is, she acts like we aren't even there. Her head's in a crowd.
In the clouds.
That's what I said. In the clouds.
Well, she does have a lot on her mind. When did you last see her?
Not long ago. Right after she got back from saving you from Stoneir.
Then it's probably just about the Enterprise. It did take quite a battering on the way there and back.
You didn't break it, did you, Sid? You really should be more careful around Miss Middadol's inventions.
Oh, don't listen to her. Even if you did break the Enterprise, you could put it back together, couldn't you?
But who's going to put Miss Middadol back together? She seems really sad.
Why don't I go and see if I can cheer her up?
You do that, for us.
She's in her dungeon.
Don't scare him. It's not a real dungeon.
Thanks for the warning.
Miss Shirley says we're not allowed in the dungeon. But Miss Middadol doesn't mind.
Has Middadol mentioned a new project yet?
Not exactly.
She seems preoccupied.
Mid, if you have a...
That's it! I knew it! The answer was right here under my arse all along! If this doesn't steer to the skies, nothing will.
To the skies? You aren't trying to give the Enterprise wings, are you?
What else would I be doing?
The children seem to think you're avoiding them. They're worried about you. Is this really so important that you need to shut yourself away from everyone?
The Enterprise is already the fastest ship in the realm, and that's with the sea beneath her. But what if she weren't bound to the waves? What if she weren't bound to anything at all? It's not fair. The gods get the skies all to themselves, so I'm going to do something about it. The Fallen had their chance, but they relied too much on magic. And see where that got them. But not me. I've discovered how to do it without. Well, almost. First, I need to make a prototype.
And is that a one-woman job?
Are you volunteering? I'll have you know the Enterprise is my baby. But
If her godfather's offering to lend a hand, I'd be happy to take it. First, I'll need oil, and not just some old drippings from Miss Molly's spits in the Tub and Crown. Refined stuff, like they make in Ordil. Then I'll need some bone, or shell. Light, strong, preferably no longer attached to the beast it belongs to.
If it's beast bones you're after, I'm sure the curse breakers will know where you might find some.
No, they'll know where you might find some. You're the one who offered to help, remember?
I should speak with one of the curse breakers before I set off for Old Hill. See if I can't find this bone while I'm there as well.
They make an oil down at the docks in Aldil that's as slippery as the sea nasties they render it from. With that and the bone I told you about, I shall be able to finish the prototype.
Something to ask. Ask. I'll be here if you need me.
All right, Sid. Come to buy us a round, have you?
Only if you earn it. Mid needs a piece of light but durable bone for her next project. You've encountered your share of beasts on your travels across the realm. Any ideas?
Most bones are the same. Whack 'em hard enough and they'll break. If it's durability you're looking for, shell will serve you better. You know what an adamantus is?
I do. And I know to give them a wide berth. Will any old adamantus do?
Well, with shells, the older the harder. There's a rumour of an ancient adamantus down in Carava, near Ul Bidza, or what's left of the village anyway. But don't expect to make quick work of the bastard. There's a reason it's lived as long as it has.
I'll keep that in mind. Thank you.
Normally, I wouldn't recommend going anywhere near an adamantus, let alone one that's had a few centuries to let its temper simmer. They're mean bastards, and they only get meaner with age. Why do you think the village of Ul Bidza was abandoned?
Sid, I was wondering if you could help me.
It depends what with.
A bearer, but recently freed from his bonds, is keen to join the Curse Breakers. As you know, the work we do is not easy, which is why we test every volunteer's suitability. I was hoping you could oversee this one's evaluation.
I don't mind, but why this one?
Because he wants to be a scout. Our ranks are filled with men and women capable of breaking chains and putting slavers to the sword. But scouting? We're few with the nose for that, which is why we still rely so heavily on Gav. And since he accompanies you on so many of your missions, I thought you might be better placed to recognize the traits in him that we should look for in those who'd fill his boots.
Sounds reasonable.
So you're happy to oversee the boy's test, then?
One can never have too many scouts.
Truer words, Sid. I'll let the initiate know that you'll be attending his trial, and that he is to proceed directly to Northreach in readiness.
No time like the present, eh?
No time like the present. I'll await you there.
Northreach. I don't suppose they could have chosen somewhere closer. Mid's oil. After what happened here, it's a miracle there was any left at all.
Stay down! Should be enough.
Welcome to Dravosh, Sid. Our gate's always open for you and yours.
You're the one who butchered those Akashic fiends, aren't you? We're in your debt.
What do you think? I made myself a pair of bellows, just like Blackthorn shot.
Ah, Sid. Safe travels.
It was a nasty gash, that demon.
Girl, run like the wind. Here we are again. Karava, if you were a tortoise, Togo, where would you hide? Looks like we found him. Too slow.
Ah!
I better get these materials to Mid so she can finish her prototype. Good girl.
Faster!
Thank you.
off.
Rest in peace. Come on.
Fly, Ambrosia.
Can walk from here. This must be the orphanage. Hopefully the registry is still here. Disposed of. Conditioning. This is nothing short of torture. Herman wasn't exaggerating. It's a wonder he survived this place. I need to find that registry. This reads like a suicide note. Did the director go through with his plan? There's only one way to find out. Forked white tree. This must be the place. Could he really be buried here? There's something hidden among the roots. Let's see. This must be the registry. So many names. This place was a slaughterhouse. the architect of all this misery. It was only a matter of time, I suppose. This place is cursed.
Let darkness fall!
I'm done here. Let's get the registry back to Herman. Azair might at least have mentioned where in Northreach he'd be testing this recruit.
Who'd you think?
I'm nervous. Is it all right to be nervous?
I don't care either way, so long as you do as I tell you. Well met, Sid. This is the initiate. Ember, present yourself.
At your service, Master.
Please, just Sid. There are no masters here. Your life is your own.
Oh, of course. Thank you, Sid. The sergeant says you'll be evaluating me at my trial.
To become a scout, yes. You are aware of the dangers inherent in that role.
I am, but I swore I'd face them, just like the man who saved my life.
And who would that be?
Gav. It was him who found me and freed me. No magic. No support, just one man and his nose. Came and sniffed me out. It taught me what one man can do if he puts his mind to it. And I've been training ever since, so that one day I can be someone's saviour, just like Gav was mine.
I'm sure he'd be flattered. You clearly have good intentions, Ember. And it sounds like you're under no illusions. Stick to this path and you'll make a fine Cursebreaker.
So... what? Have I passed?
You haven't even started yet. Now listen. Not far from here is an Imperial lookout, East Watch. The guards there record all their sightings in a logbook. You are to find it and bring it here.
And bring it here, right. Anything else?
No. Sneaking into a heavily guarded Imperial outpost and stealing the logbook would be quite sufficient. You will need to assess the situation, determine a point of entry, create a distraction and effect an escape, all without being discovered and thrown into an Imperial oubliette.
Ember, Gav isn't our best scout because he can do everything. It's essential that you know your limits.
Know my limits, right. I won't let you down.
It shouldn't be as dangerous as I made out. But keep a weather eye on him all the same, would you?
On my way. All right, Ember. Impress me.
Even now, the capital has moved. The Empire keeps the watchtowers overlooking Royal Meadows and the Sea of Grace manned. But only by a skeleton crew. It's a trial, not a death sentence.
Let's go. These are clean kills. Perhaps young Ember really is ready. Ah! Or maybe not. Damn it.
Ember, draw your sword!
I can't!
Then run!
If you want him,
you'll have to go through me.
Ember, are you? Gone. Of course. Scouts really are a rare breed. Back to Northreach it is then. Come on.
Faster.
straight home now.
I didn't expect you back so soon. Where is Ember? How did he fare?
I thought I'd find him with you. He must have fled. I followed him to Eastwatch, where I found him being set upon by a wild Avis. He was just standing there. Didn't even draw his sword. I had to step in and take care of things. But by the time I had, he was nowhere to be seen. I assumed he'd set off in your direction, but apparently not.
I'm sorry, Sid. I knew the boy had a nervous streak, but he seemed like
the right man for the job. I believe this is the logbook you tasked me with retrieving.
Hey? How did you... Don't you tell me you breached the tower while Sid was busy saving your skin.
What? Wasn't that what you asked me to do? To bring the thing back without getting caught?
He has you there, Nazaire. And he did it all on his own.
But Sid, he...
He did what he thought was best. And now I have to decide whether I agree.
Of course. We'll await your evaluation back at the hideaway. Don't you leave my sight.
Yes, Sergeant.
This won't be an easy decision.
Should have seen him. The thing didn't stand a chance.
Yeah, neither did you, I hear. Welcome back, Sid.
Welcome back, Sid.
Yes. Welcome back. Trip wasn't too much of a pain in the arse, I hope. Truth be told, it was me who suggested roping you in to help with the trial. But from what I hear, things didn't go quite as planned.
No, they most certainly did not. Ember lost his nerve in the face of a beast of prey, but he didn't lose heart. He pressed on, and he achieved his aim. And is that not what we ask of our scouts?
Indeed it is. Thank you for your honest appraisal, Sid. The fact remains, however, that Ember will not always have a battle-hardened warrior on hand to pluck him from the jaws of peril. All I have gleaned from this trial is that without someone watching his back, Ember is little more than a liability.
Wait, Sergeant. Ember still has much to learn, it's true. And this time he was found wanting. But I'd say he's due a second chance, nonetheless. After all, he did do as you asked.
With a bit of hard work, any hand can be made to hold a blade, and any mind can conquer its fears. But a scout's nose is different. You've either got one, or you ain't. And by sniffing out that log, young Ember here has shown he has a conch and a half. Wouldn't do to waste it now, would it?
Fine. One more chance.
I'll do whatever you ask. I'll spend my days and nights in the pit if I have to. I'll show you. Just you wait.
Daft as a brush, there, hon. But his heart's in the right place. Just like someone else we know. And if you ask me, we've been leaning on him for far too long. That time the Curse Breakers took some of the weight off his shoulders, I reckon.
You couldn't hurt.
Just don't tell Gav I said so, will you? I won't have him thinking he's been hard done by. Next thing you know, he'd be asking for a day off. Chance would be a fine thing. Back to work.
Forgive me, Sid. This did not play out as I expected.
Things rarely do these days. But that's why we need men like Ember more than ever. Men who can make the best out of a bad situation. Remember that.
I will, Sid. Thank you. Sid, I wanted you to know. I will be taking personal responsibility for Ember's combat training. And I will not let you down. Sid, I wanted you to know. I will be taking personal responsibility for Ember's...
Tell me this is all you need.
Ah, you make it sound like I asked you to save the world or something.
Tell me this is all you need.
It's most of what I need. After you left, I went over the figures again, and I realized I'd forgotten a one and a zero.
And
a cogwheel. Just a tiny one. Though, that's the problem. Gears that small are a bastard to make, and I may have lost the one Blackthorn spent a fortnight toiling over.
Wait. The children. When they took apart your scales, there was a tiny brass gear. Now that I think about it, they didn't use it when we put the scales back together.
The young'uns? But why would the... You know what? I don't want to know. I'll keep working on the model. You go and find that cog. Don't look at me like that, Clive. I already apologized to Blackthorn. Miserable old bugger. Besides, you can't expect me to keep track of every nut and nail floating about this place. It's a mess!
Middadol mentioned a new project yet?
Not exactly.
She seems pretty...
Sid! Is Mid still hiding from us?
She wasn't hiding. She's fine. She's just busy working on her next project.
A new invention? What is it? What is it?
Is it an airship?
I bet it's an airship!
Do you think she'll let us help?
That just so happens to be why I'm here. She needs something special, something only you three can provide. A brass gear. A tiny one. One that might fit on, say, a set of scales?
Oh, the one you forgot! We remember!
We saved it, just in case. It's in the bag of bits.
Since your lesson, we've been disassembling, then reassembling everything we can find.
All the pieces that are left over, we keep under our beds, just in case.
That's good to know.
Look! I found it! Is that all? Just the gear? We have more parts if Mid needs them.
That's all for now. But I'll let Mid know about your... board. Just in case.
Thanks, Sid. Back for another part. We've got screws and bolts and nails and knobbles and noodles and,
Well, did they have it?
They did. And they kept it somewhere nice and safe. Will it work?
Will it work? He's perfect! You're a genius, Clive.
What exactly are you going to use it for?
Only the most important job of all. The wings aren't going to move on their own. But with the right cog in the right place... Well, you just wait and see. Should do her. Here goes nothing. Titan's tits.
It wasn't supposed to fly, was it?
Of course it was supposed to fly. Wouldn't be much of an airship if it didn't. Honestly, these bloody engines are driving me mad. I was so sure this would be the day she soared. The Mithril engine was made to make dreams come true. But maybe this is one dream the world's better off without. Show folk how to take flying. It won't be long till they're raining death down on each other. People will lose their homes, children, their mums, and their dads. Like I lost mine.
I'm sorry.
So am I, Clive. So am I. Sorry that I have to choose. Do I follow my head, or do I follow my heart?
Good question. The first time I stood on the deck of your ship, felt the wind in my hair. It was like I was flying, but imagine how it would feel to actually do it.
My dad always said there were two ways of living life, chasing a dream or shuffling to your grave. And he were right. Right about a lot of things. Not that I like to admit it. People need dreams to chase. Especially in a world like this. Right. When this is over, I'm gonna take all my Mithril engines to Zemeckis and sling them over the edge. I won't have my dream end up turning into someone else's nightmare.
But all that hard work...
All that hard work will not be used for war, Jamie. But it ain't like it'll be gone. Tell me, Clive. Have you ever been on a treasure hunt?
Not since Joshua and I were boys. Why do you ask?
Because I'm going to bury the engine schematics and leave behind a little riddle telling people where to find them. A really hard one, so that only the most dedicated dreamers will ever be able to work it out. Ooh, I can picture it now. Some daft general squinting at the words with a gormless expression on his mug. Like that one, yeah.
Right.
Of course, if I'm putting this engine at the end of a treasure hunt, I'll still need to make it a treasure worth hunting for. Won't be much of a prize if it couldn't even make a toy boat fly after all. My dad always said, dream big. But it ain't the size of a dream that's important, is it, Clive? Only that it's a good one. And I reckon I've got a fair few good uns left in me.
I'm sure you do. What shall I do with your model? You spent a lot of time on it. We both did.
What, that old thing? Not healthy to cling to your failures, Clive. They'll weigh you down, you know.
Sound advice.
Still, I suppose my prototypes will probably be worth a fair bit when I'm as famous as Bart's the Builder. Seeing as you're always strapped for coin, suppose I can give it to you. Just make sure you get a good price when you do come to part with it.
I'd say that was up to you as much as me.
All right, Clive. Enjoy it while you can, Clive. Imagine that, eh? Till then, though. Be seeing you, Clive.
I hear that you traveled to Ash, Cid. Did you by any chance recover the names of my fallen friends?
I did. Yes.
If I may, the Bearer Registry. The Director was a brutal man. He got no worse than he deserved.
The registry was all I found beneath the tree. There was no sign of a body. Nor any record of what happened to the children after the orphanage closed.
I pray that at least some of them survived. All their names are here. The ones we lost. My friends. My light in those dark times. I can still remember their faces. Like it was yesterday. Children who were taken from their bunks in the morning, never to return. No explanation ever offered.
They'd be happy to know that you survived, Herman.
But why did I make it out alive when so many others died in that awful place?
It's not your fault. And blaming yourself won't bring them back. Honor their memory. See that their names live on. That way, at least. They're never truly gone.
Thank you. Cid, I'm going to write a book. An account of the horrors of Badbach, and the spirit of those its custodians sought to crush. All of Valisthea will know of our suffering. And in the name of those I lost, I will not let it happen again.
Neither will I.
These records would have been buried for all eternity, were it not for you. Thank you. Realm will hear of Badbach. And I pray that the tale of my fallen friends will spare future generations the horror we endured. Thank you for helping keep their memory alive.